Hi, I'm Ella and I'm the Plants Meow and welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a video about something a lot of people message me about. I get Instagram messages, YouTube comments, and emails all about this because I import a lot of plants. And the topic today is all about acclimation. So to be honest, when I first started receiving these questions and messages, it hadn't even occurred to me to actually do something special for my plants in regard to acclimation. But that was mainly due to the fact that I was pretty much doing it intuitively without really thinking about it. But I'll pretty much go over here the things that I do. I don't think I do anything really special. I do something special now, but that's because it's more winter time. So in the summertime, the tolerance is a bit different for plants that are getting imported in. And during wintertime, you're gonna be in for kind of new battles with your plants. Oh, really quickly, I just wanted to show off my Majesty. So I actually got her off someone on eBay, and the seller's handle is MDA1515. It's actually the same seller that I got my Philodendron Dark Lord. So I'm so happy to have the sister plant now. And I have a little one of this, which I'll be selling sometime soon, but I'm super stoked to finally just have this large specimen. It's just super gorgeous. Also, I'm repping a little bit of Harley G merch today. So when you get a new plant, it's gonna be adjusting to a lot of different things. The light in your house, the temperature, the pH, the altitude, the humidity. There's a lot of different things that your plant's gonna be kind of balancing. And it's gonna have struggles in the beginning, especially if it wasn't receiving the exact same kind of environment beforehand. So with importing plants, this is always the greatest struggle. And also the process of shipping is incredibly stressful on these plants. So they're coming from overseas, and depending how they're packed, they may not be doing the best. A lot of times there could be bacterial issues, rot issues, some pests. I think scale is the main issue, just because through quarantine there really shouldn't be any other pests on there that they've inspected, but scale just happens to slip under that radar. But honestly, scale is super easy. If you do happen to find it on your plant, just take a Q-tip and put a little bit of hydrogen peroxide, I use the 3% kind, on it, and then just kind of put it on top of it and then wipe them off. So they come off pretty easy. They like to kind of stick on there, but that hydrogen peroxide to really help you get them off. So additionally, I use a systemic. The systemic that I use is the Bonide systemic granules, and that actually kills things that feed on your foliage. So it'll work on not things just like scale, but also mealybugs, thrips, and many other different kinds of pests. So the first thing you wanna do is make sure your temperature is pretty ideal. So that means keeping your temperature probably at or above 70 degrees. And if you're not able to maintain that in your home in the beginning specifically, then I would suggest getting a heat mat. A lot of times, either way, even if you can maintain that temperature, a lot of people do opt to get a heat mat. I, for reasons I'll talk about later in the video, don't really use mine, but I do have one just in case I need it. So also you wanna make sure your humidity is really good. So in the summertime, our humidity is usually pretty awesome. Some people augment their humidity with a humidifier as well. And honestly, how I keep my temperature and humidity really great is my indoor greenhouse. So the best piece of advice I could really give you, the almost kind of foolproof way to acclimate your plants, is an indoor greenhouse. So you can get one of those small ones that are just fit in a tight corner and they're tall, or you can get one that's a little bit bigger. I have a, I would say, medium-sized one, and then I also have a large one, but only buy the large one if you're actually capable of filling it with a lot of plants, because for me, I don't like to additionally put a humidifier in there. It's enough to fill it with plants, and the humidity will stay at 90% based on the one I've made a greenhouse tour on. So 90% humidity is excellent. You really don't need to go any higher. So having too high of humidity and too high temperature could possibly melt some plants. I know my philodendrons favor these conditions much less. My anthuriums quite love them. And then for my larger greenhouse, I finally got a decent amount of plants in there. And no, that is not one I have shown you guys, but that one stays at about 75% humidity. which I would deem really good, but not the greatest. So definitely that medium to small size is probably the best if you're looking to just have a greenhouse in order to acclimate plants. So another thing is light intensity. So when you first get a plant, it's been in a box for a few days and you should not put it right in front of direct sunlight, even bright indirect sunlight. Your plant needs to adjust back to that light level. It will pretty much stress it out if you put it in front of a light right away. So what I do in my greenhouse is I pick a corner where my light isn't facing and kind of gets that dappled light and it's not sitting directly in front of it. And if you're curious about my exact indoor greenhouse conditions and you haven't watched my greenhouse tour, I will link it at the end of this video just so you can kind of see what I'm talking about here. So also when acclimating new plants, you want to make sure the soil composition you're giving them is very well draining. So you could also do sphagnum moss. I don't particularly lean towards sphagnum moss just because I'm not a fan of having to repot it again. I think that further stresses the plant and I don't think it's necessary. I've never had the need to do it. I've just put them straight in soil and they've been completely fine that way. But also note, if you have received a plant that has been wrapped in sphagnum moss that is much more wet than how you would typically like to receive the plant, keep in mind that you shouldn't heavily water this plant because that could actually further some bacterial issues that are already coming along. If you watch my cleaning new plants video, you can see in that video that I do treat for that with Ficin 20, but also it's important to not give them too much in the beginning. On the other hand, if they come with nothing on the roots, nothing at all, which I've had happen, and that's been my best water since, you're fine to water them. They shouldn't have any issues. I'm not saying underwater or just trickle. That's silly. I'm saying just to do a good once over, but don't have it so it's completely soaked and pouring through. I know you're repotting a plant, you think you should water it very heavily, but I'm telling you, in cases where they have very established root systems that have been soaking for too long, it will be a huge issue to do so. So I have never done this, but another thing that you could do if you do have a very established root system on your plant that has been soaking is to let it dry a bit. That thought scares me a bit, but that is a possibility that you could do. So I use a gallon of distilled water and I put a 1/4 teaspoon of Super Thrive in there to help with transplant shock. I use that and then I sprinkle some hydrogen peroxide in there in order to kind of aerate things as I water it, just in case there is some kind of issue within the soil. But honestly, I feel like I don't do anything crazy. For the most part, I clean my plants, pot them up, and I put them in my greenhouse, and they're usually good to go. I don't really have any special tips and tricks. Those are just the kind of things that I do. I feel like if you're going crazy with this whole acclimation thing, for me, it's a bit too time consuming to do something extra than that. Honestly, but you do you. If you feel like you need to do some more extra steps for acclimation, do it, because these are expensive plants. I wouldn't want to tell you to not do something when you're investing on all of these plants. It's important that you do everything you can to help them acclimate as best as you can. And going forward, I treat them like every other plant. I have them on the same watering schedule as all my other plants, and I haven't really had issues like that. But I have noticed this winter, and this is the first winter I'm having with the very high humidity plants, it was definitely an issue importing plants and not putting them in my greenhouse right away. I actually left them out overnight in my plant room, so it was about 55 to 60% humidity, but that clearly was just not hitting it. You know, they weren't acclimated and they freaked out. So I immediately that morning put them in my greenhouse and they've been slowly getting better. That definitely shows me right there with them getting better like that, that is the ideal place for them to be, and that winters are much more harsher than summertime. I thought I had a good climate going on inside my house, but they have told me otherwise. I haven't had issues with my other plants because they're all acclimated, so they're used to my 55 to 60% humidity, and they don't argue with me. And that includes my anthuriums, like my queen anthurium, who does perfectly fine at my 55%, and honestly, it pretty much stays at 55% because I'm scared of mold. No mold in the house. I don't know what I'm talking about. But yeah, So I hope this was marginally helpful for you. I've been getting this a lot, so I really want to kind of put this out there to just kind of tell you guys what I personally do. And I'll leave you with a few quick tidbits at the end. Make sure you're using lukewarm or room temperature water. Keep your pH around 5.5 to 6. Our tropical plants actually prefer a little bit less than neutral. So yeah, I know that's probably not going to be a little happy thing for people to think about. So I wanted to quickly show you inside of my greenhouse because I know a lot of people get discouraged about plants when they acclimate, about losing their leaves. And that certainly happened to me too. And I want to tell you, it's really nothing to be discouraged about when you're importing plants or having plants acclimate. Sometimes, especially with anthuriums, they're going to lose their leaves. So I have two here that are essentially back from the dead. So I have my Crystallinum Doriaki hybrid, and it's brand new leaf and super happy about that. It actually took quite a few months for me to even get this leaf, so I'm super thrilled it's finally here. This one, I think it took about a month and a half, but finally here, it's my Anthurium Regale. And super happy about how that's coming about. That sinus is really nice, which is one of the reasons I purchased this particular specimen, is because he had a really good looking one. So I have another Regale, and I'm just going to be keeping both of them because they're both unique and I'm very attached to the other one, but I really want one that looks like this. And also, if we look down here, I do have some Queens enduring some acclimation. So stuff like this on the edges of your leaf is just gonna be normal. I'm just lucky I didn't lose these leaves. And this tells me, because they've been here a few weeks now, that I'm not going to lose these leaves. They're pretty good. And the reason behind that is because these plants were from here in the US. But a lot of times when you import plants, it's just gonna happen. So here's one over here that is actually losing a leaf, but I have full confidence that he'll come back. I have some here. So you can see this back one is getting lost, but I think he's finally stabilized because this leaf isn't going anywhere. Actually, probably gonna remove that one right after this. I try to leave them on as long as I can just because they can suck the nutrients out of them, but I also don't want decomposing matter that looks really bad to just stay on them for the longest time. And you can see this leaf is being lost. So I just want to be completely transparent. I don't want anyone ever to get discouraged with this plant hobby and give up on a plant or give up on plants entirely because they think they're doing something wrong. And I think that would just be awful. I definitely want all of us to succeed, and I want everyone to have plants that are thriving. So if you ever have any questions, just feel free to ask me. I don't mind at all. At the end of the day, it's really about enjoying these guys and helping them to survive and live their best planty life. But thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a like. If you want to see more content, please subscribe. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your wonderful week.